Welcome back for another edition of Calhoun County's Most Wanted, the program where you get to help make Calhoun County a better and safer place for all of us by helping us lock up some bad guys. I'm your host, Chris Wright, along with Calhoun County Chief Deputy Matthew Wade. Matthew, how you doing?
Hey, I'm doing good. Almost spring's in the air, a little warm temperatures, baseball, softball's going on. That's great stuff.
Yeah, things are starting to look a little bit better. That winter lasted a little bit longer than I wanted it
was. Now if we just get the rain to slow down a hair, you know, get more baseball and softball games in, we'll be so
the rain's going to be here. It's March. We're going to be seeing
March,
some rain.
It's March. I know it seems like it's been raining since October or November, but hey, warm weather is at least a start.
Yeah, and of course now getting into April, which will be the Child Abuse Prevention and Awareness Month, and we're going to see the pinwheels going up. Are they going up today?
Pinwheels are being put up as we speak. Of course, this is Tuesday, about lunchtime, but 430 pinwheels are right there on Quintard between Walgreens and the Alabama Power Company. When you see them, there's a big sign there talking about the Calhoun and Cleburne Children's Center. Those 430 pinwheels represents 430 children they interviewed during this past year. You know, some say, wow, that's a lot. It is a lot, and I'd like to see less, but you know, we don't determine crime. Crime happens whether we're here or not, but what the Children's Center does, they go after those reported cases aggressively. They do it forensically. They do it in a way where the child is protected. The child is not exposed to any more than they absolutely have to be exposed to, and this protocol is followed by every law enforcement agency in Calhoun County. It is truly a God-sent program that's helping children each and every day.
If there's 430 pinwheels, that's 430 kids that they interviewed. That doesn't necessarily mean that there were 430 victims, but generally speaking, if somebody's being interviewed by the Children's Center, something's not right in that situation.
Something's not right. Somebody's reported something. Sometimes it's just as equally important to prove somebody guilty. It's just as equally important to prove if somebody didn't do it.
Right.
You know, we're looking for facts, not a scapegoat. We're looking to see where it goes. And these people are specifically trained on how to do it forensically. I mean, science is involved. They do it in a way that a patrol deputy's not going, hey, tell me what happened, or somebody that doesn't do it every day or interviews different types of crimes. This protocol is very successful, very good, and we're really blessed to have it here in Calhoun and Cleburne County.
Yeah, if you spend all day dealing with people who are criminals, interviewing a child may not be the thing that comes most natural to you.
No, and the people that do this, the children don't even know that they're being interviewed most of the time. The way it's done and the way it's set up, they're not in a government building where the walls, and you know, they don't feel that way. It's in a home-type environment. Cameras are hidden. They just have a conversation with a licensed counselor that knows how to do this, that knows how to deal with children, and you know, it's done in a good way.
I guess the point for the viewing public as we're having this discussion is we have a great facility here, some great people with the Calhoun Cleburne Children's Center who are able to do an excellent job of determining whether or not something wrong is going on with a child involved. So if anybody has suspicions about anything with a child, they should feel very confident about reporting that so that it will be properly investigated.
Absolutely. And reporting is always what you want to do. And sometimes families get upset with law enforcement when they report it and they say, well, talk to my child, he'll tell you. And go, oh, we can't do that. They go, well, you need to just let them tell you. No, there's a protocol. And we let the people, let professionals handle it. And everybody's got to know their limits, and we follow that protocol. Reporting it, it's like I said, sometimes people are not guilty. Sometimes it didn't happen that way. Sometimes it did. And when it does, we want to be able to successfully prosecute anybody that hurts a child. We want to have no mercy on them, and we want to make sure that we can prosecute them and get them convicted of what they did. Gathering information, gathering evidence in the proper way is crucial to making that happen.
All right. Well, you guys continue to bring the information to us. This past week, you've done another great job helping us find some more individuals that were on our wanted list.
Six arrests. Count goes up to 3,339 people put in jail.
Actually, 3,345. That was the number we had last week.
I'm reading the wrong number. I'm sorry, I can't see. But 3,345 people put in jail all because somebody got involved. Somebody is willing to contact us and let us know where these people are. And, you know, there's only 54 deputies in the county. We need a force multiplier. That's what these TV deputies do each and every week for us.
Absolutely.
We appreciate that.
We thank you for doing that. We're going to take a quick break, and then we'll show you the first half of this week's lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
For emergency and non-emergency medical transportation, you can count on Anniston EMS.
Hello, I'm Johnny Warren with Anniston EMS, and we appreciate the opportunity to provide support for the Calhoun County's Most Wanted program. And I would like to remind everyone out there that if they need any medical transportation needs, please don't hesitate to call us.
Call Anniston EMS at 256-237-8572.
Big news for homebuyers searching through all those complicated mortgage options. AOD Federal Credit Union is now offering new, out-of-the-box mortgage solutions. Mortgage loan manager Jamie Bailey will help find the best rates and quickest approval for you. Conventional, FHA, VA, USDA, Jumbo, HARP, and more. Call Jamie Bailey at 256-241-8218. Out-of-the-box mortgage services. Reason number 4, that you belong with AOD Federal Credit Union. Federally insured by NCUA. All loans subject to credit approval. Certain restrictions apply. Equal housing lender.
The Ford brand has always brought you impressive style and legendary quality. And Sonny King Ford brings you the lowest price and the largest inventory, new or pre-owned. The new 2015 F-150 gets the best gas mileage of any truck without giving up its powerful towing capacity. The iconic new 2015 Mustang with its classic pony car looks and hunkered down stance preserves a legacy that defines American motoring. For over 93 years, Sonny King Ford for the best cars and best price.
Hi, I'm Katina Houston with Family Links, and this is the Parenting Tip of the Week. With April quickly approaching, I'm proud to announce that April is Child Abuse Prevention Month. The Child Abuse Prevention and Treatment Act, otherwise known as CAPTA, was the first federal child protection legislation signed by President Nixon on January 31, 1974, and marked the beginning of a new national response to the problem of child abuse and neglect. The legislation provided federal assistance to states for prevention, identification, and treatment programs. It also created the National Center on Child Abuse and Neglect, known now as the Office on Child Abuse and Neglect, within the Children's Bureau to serve as a federal focal point for CAPTA activities. Today, CAPTA, most recently reauthorized in 2010, continues to provide minimum standards for child maltreatment definitions and support states' prevention and intervention efforts. In 1983, President Reagan proclaimed April to be the first National Child Abuse Prevention Month, a tradition that continues to this day. As we at Family Links know, the future prosperity of any community depends on its ability to foster the health and well-being of the next generation. When a community invests wisely in children and families, the next generation will pay that back through a lifetime of productivity and responsible citizenship. Yet, when not all children have equal opportunity for healthy growth and development due to experiences of child abuse and neglect, we put our future at risk. While April is Child Abuse Prevention Month, you can make a big difference year-round through small acts that help protect children, strengthen families, promote traits that help protect families, and ultimately, prevent the abuse and neglect of children. The theme for this year's National Child Abuse Prevention Month continues to be making meaningful connections. When we make meaningful connections with the children, youth, and families in our communities, we can help parents build the knowledge and skills and assess the resources necessary to raise happy and healthy children. Over the month of April, I will share ways that we, as a community member, can get involved in making a difference. Remember, everyone can play a role in preventing child abuse and neglect and promoting child and family well-being. For more tips like this, please call Family Links at 256-820-5911.
Let's get started with this week's lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted. Remember, if you recognize somebody and know where they can be found, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers, 256-338-1414. Juan Ruiz of Albertville is our first person today. He is wanted on probation revocation for trafficking cocaine. Ronnie Phillips of Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for trafficking in marijuana. Emilio Bryant of Oxford, probation violation for distribution of a controlled substance, possession of marijuana first degree, and obstruction of justice, false ID. Ginger Couch is from Anniston, wanted on probation revocation for theft of property, second degree. Marvin Blackburn of Rome, Georgia, wanted in Calhoun County
for probation revocation for possession of a controlled substance. DeWanda Ellis of Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for theft of property, second degree. And Allie Boykin of Anniston, wanted on probation revocation for possession and receipt of controlled substance. If you have any information about these cases, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers, 256-238-1414.
We're not done with the bad guys. We've got a few more of those to show you here in just a few minutes. But right now, David West is joining us, the coordinator for the Calhoun County Extension Service. This is the busy time of year for you, isn't it, David?
Well, it's kind of got over my career where all the seasons are busy because we have a full office staff. And so different programs are more popular at different times. But for us in the area of horticulture and outdoors types activities, this is a busy time of year for us. As farmers markets are getting ready to go, and we've got 4-H contests that are coming up, and then we've got several educational programs that are coming up as well.
All right, the big question, is it time to go ahead and take your stuff outside, plant things outside, or do we need to wait? Are we going to have one more, you think?
I would generally wait. Usually I tell folks to wait until at least April 15th, and so, you know, you can get over the stress of taxes and then go plant your garden. And really, you don't gain a lot of time if our temperatures and our soil temperatures haven't, you know, gotten up to an adequate level. You're not going to gain any time because your crop's likely to fail, because when we have those cool soil temperatures, we're more likely to get diseases, and our crop's not going to mature like we'd like to. So wait until it's time. We've got some farmers for our farmers markets who are using hoop houses to capture some of that solar energy and get their crops in earlier. And so I hope that they'll be successful and be able to have more fruits and vegetables at our markets earlier this year.
I know the downtown market in Anniston just opened up this past weekend.
Yes.
And they'll be going every Saturday morning up until the end of October. So things are starting to go. Probably not as much on display right now as there will be in a couple of months.
Oh, no, there's not much of anything out there right now except maybe some collards and greens. And strawberries will be coming in the next few weeks for folks. But it'll be, you know, May, June, July when we start getting other crops in. And like I said, some of these folks with hoop houses, they'll be bringing their crop in a month earlier than folks who are just using standard production.
If you've got a watermelon patch, you don't need to let Matthew know where it is.
That is true.
You will see a watermelon just thrown out in the middle of the patch, the core eaten out of it, right, Matthew?
That is it. There'll be an empty salt shaker laying next to it.
And that's policy for inspection, right?
That is policy for inspection.
There we go.
A core inspection.
That is the best part of the watermelon, right there in the middle. I love it. I hate this time of the year when you start seeing watermelons in the grocery stores and it's so tempting. Oh, I want that watermelon. I haven't had a watermelon in so long. Give me that watermelon. But you know it's just not going to taste like a watermelon in the middle of July.
No, it's not. And you think about your watermelons, cantaloupes, tomatoes, and strawberries. If you've never had a strawberry that you picked ripe, it's a big difference in the strawberries that you can buy that have been shipped versus a strawberry that has been picked ripe. So, you know, a lot of times folks will sprinkle sugar on some of those you buy at the store, but if you buy a strawberry that has ripened on the plant,
you don't need it.
You don't need to add that sugar. So,
well, let's talk about some of the events that we've got coming up.
Okay. Well, one thing we have coming up soon is our Master Gardener plant sale, which benefits our Tree Amigos 4-H program, and that'll be April 11th out at Cane Creek Community Gardens. And so that's the most pressing thing that we have coming up. We also have a cottage food class coming up. Now, in Alabama, it's legal for folks to make some things, cakes, jams, jellies, those types of things, at their home and sell them. But you have to have the cottage food training before you can do that legally. And so we have a cottage food class coming up on May 19th. And one of our regional agents, Patty West, comes in and conducts that training for us. And folks, it's a day-long training that folks are able to take their certificate back with them, and then they're able to legally sell those goods that they make at home.
And it doesn't just make you legal, it also actually gives you some good knowledge.
Absolutely. And that's one of the things that we encourage folks who sell at our farmers markets and things as well to take some of these classes, because it helps you think about food safety and food handling, and so much about just the simple things that you can do in terms of washing hands and not cross-contaminating fruits and vegetables or meats or whatever that you're working with. That's one of those things that's a good food safety factor. And so if folks will just learn those basics, it helps them do a better job.
So we're confident then that if we go to one of the local farmers markets, the people that we see selling items out there have had this training?
It's not required for our farmers markets.
Is it not? Okay.
It is required for folks selling from their home, if they're selling baked goods from their home.
Okay.
But we have encouraged our farmers market folks to have this training as well. It's things that are not inspected by the health department, but they need this training to help them. It's only $25, and it'll be in May at the office, and they can register on our website.
Okay, I think we've got some other events we want to talk about as well, but before we do that, we need to take a break, and we will come back. We'll have the second half of this week's lineup and more about the planting season and all that with David West here on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
Amazing grace.
How sweet the sound that saved.
A crackhead.
Drug addict.
Alcoholic.
Meth freak.
A wretch.
Like me.
I once was.
Homeless.
Broken. Sad.
Just lost.
But now I am.
Sober. Happy.
I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see.
Every day, shattered lives are restored thanks to the goods you donate to the Salvation Army.
Your word is rigmarole.
Can you define it?
A long, complicated, and annoying process.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The last time I tried to buy a car, I just got a big load of rigmarole.
Well, you should have gone to Jacksonville Auto Sales.
Jacksonville Auto Sales, across from Walmart in Jacksonville, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
Big news for homebuyers searching through all those complicated mortgage options. AOD Federal Credit Union is now offering new, out-of-the-box mortgage solutions. Mortgage loan manager Jamie Bailey will help find the best rates and quickest approval for you. Conventional, FHA, VA, USDA, Jumbo, HARP, and more. Call Jamie Bailey at 256-241-8218. Out-of-the-box mortgage services. Reason number 4, that you belong with AOD Federal Credit Union. Federally insured by NCUA. All loans subject to credit approval. Certain restrictions apply. Equal housing lender.
And the second half of our lineup this week, start with Roderick Orr of Anniston, wanted for failure to pay for second-degree possession of marijuana. Crystal Wilson of East Tiboga, failure to pay for use of possession of drug paraphernalia. Jabril Clark from Anniston, wanted for failure to appear for possession of marijuana second degree, resisting arrest, and obstruction of justice, false ID. John Fletcher of Anniston, wanted on probation revocation for third-degree theft of property. Robert Wellington of Huntsville, wanted for failure to appear for domestic violence, third-degree harassment. And Robert Howard of Delta, wanted for non-payment of child support. He owes $112,806. Again, if you have any information about these cases, please call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers at 256-238-1414. Want your information, not your name. Back to the crime fighting in just a few minutes, but David West is with us right now, the Calhoun County Extension Coordinator. A lot of people getting active out in their gardens right now, a lot of things going on, getting our hands dirty. You get your hands dirty all year, as you say, but we've got some events coming up right now that we want to make sure people know about.
One thing that's on our calendar right now this time of year is our Calhoun County Beautification Board Awards. And so during the months leading up until the end of May, we collect applications from folks. You can nominate yourself, you can nominate a friend to be a recipient of the Calhoun County Beautification Awards.
Do you ever get a joke nomination, somebody just nominates somebody that's got a really horrible yard?
Not so far, but we may now.
April Fool's Day is tomorrow.
Yeah, we may now. It's a good way to recognize folks. The commission wants to recognize people who are doing a good job making Calhoun County a better place to live. And so we have a volunteer group that serves on our Calhoun County Beautification Board. And folks mail in their nominations. It's an easy process. We just have a one-page form here. And then they can submit some pictures and write why they think someone should win the award. And our group of volunteers review those awards, and then we give out those awards later in the summer. But the cutoff date is usually the end of May. And so get those, it gives people the opportunity to get a picture of their yard while it's at peak flavor, so to speak, while they've got all those flowers blooming.
And Matthew, this isn't directly related to law enforcement, but we see time and time again, the more people invest and take pride in their homes and their neighborhoods, the more crime goes down.
Absolutely. You know, and there has been a study on that many years ago called Broken Windows Theory. More neighborhoods you go through, if there's a lot of broken windows in homes, crime's normally higher. The relativity is if you go somewhere, neighborhood's clean, people take pride in ownership, they're going to let you know if something's going on in their neighborhood that doesn't belong. So.
That's right. It makes a difference. Trees and landscaping have proven to make a difference in crime and home values. And so probably all that stuff goes together.
And another issue that we have around here is a lot of diabetics in Alabama. And so we've got something for them coming up, don't we?
We do have a lot of questions regarding diabetes and how to cook. If you're a diabetic, if you're caring for someone who's diabetic and you're preparing their meals, we have a lot of folks come in our office and ask questions. They want recipes and things like that. And so we have a diabetic cooking school coming up April 22nd, 23rd, and 24th at our Extension Auditorium. Marshall Burton in our office does the training for that. And it's a great way to come in and learn how to prepare foods that you like.
You can still enjoy eating, yes, if you're a diabetic.
Yes, you can. And Marshall does a great job of getting that information out to folks. But you are right. We do have a high instance of diabetes here in Calhoun County and the state as well. And so it's good for folks to have an opportunity to come in and learn how to prepare something that they like and that their family members will like as well, in a manner that's healthy for them to eat it.
All right, we've got just a couple of minutes left. I know that you get calls into the office on a regular basis. So what are some of the most common questions that you get and the answers that you have for them?
Well, it's usually questions like turf grass questions. My grass isn't doing well. What do I do? And we usually encourage folks to take a soil test, because you can't look at your yard, you can't look at your soil, your dirt, and decide what's in it, what nutrients are there, what the pH is, and those types of things. And so a soil test is only $7. The turnaround time with technology now, if you have email, is much shorter than it used to be, where we used to have a 2 to 3 week delay. Usually it's about a 10-day turnover now. And so if you put that email address on there, take your soil sample and send it off, then they'll send you back what's in your soil and what you can apply to help your soil situation. And that'll help out with turf, pecan trees, other fruit trees, your landscape plantings, all those types of things. A soil test is a great place to start. It's a good investment. A bag of fertilizer is $15 for just a basic bag of fertilizer, and some of these fancy grades are $40 and $50. Mm-hmm. And so if you spend $7 on that soil test, then you'll know that you're buying what it is that you need to put out there.
Is there a particular brand of grass that we can get that will grow to about this high and stay there?
I get that question. What needs no maintenance? What will grow in the shade of trees? And you know, if you go to the forest, you don't see a whole lot of grass. And when you're out hunting, you don't see a lot of grass growing in the forest either. And so if you got a lot of trees in your yard, trees and grass don't go together that well.
Yeah.
A lot of times we'll think that centipede grass is the answer to everything, and so they'll plant centipede grass, and centipede grass competes very well in places where there's no maintenance. When people put it in their yard, it's a little yellowy green, and so their neighbor has some Bermuda grass or something that's a dark green, and I need my grass to be a little greener. And so as soon as you start putting maintenance practices on that centipede grass, then it starts to decline, because the other grasses are going to outcompete it when you start fertilizing it, mowing it frequently, mowing it low, those types of things.
Knowledge is the key. You've got the answers. We've run out of time, but you'll still be there to answer the phone.
Yes, sir. We'll be there. And our Master Gardener hotline as well. If I'm not in, we have volunteers who will answer the phone for us.
All right, great. Thank you, David, for all that great knowledge and 12 months out of the year.
Thank you.
All right. We will be back with the Crazy Criminal of the Week and our Crime Stoppers segment on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.
For emergency and non-emergency medical transportation, you can count on Anniston EMS.
Hello, I'm Johnny Warren with Anniston EMS, and we appreciate the opportunity to provide support for the Calhoun County's Most Wanted program. And I would like to remind everyone out there that if they need any medical transportation needs, please don't hesitate to call us.
Call Anniston EMS at 256-237-8572.
Your word is rigmarole.
Can you define it?
A long, complicated, and annoying process.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The last time I tried to buy a car, I just got a big load of rigmarole.
Well, you should have gone to Jacksonville Auto Sales.
Jacksonville Auto Sales, across from Walmart in Jacksonville, or find us on the web at jascars.com. Remember, Jacksonville Auto Sales, home of the no rigmarole deal.
And now the Crime Stoppers segment of our show. We've got several property crimes that we need your help with. Between March 15th and 19th, residents on Nelson Avenue in Anniston were broken into. Assorted household items were stolen here. Between March 1st and 20th, an outbuilding located on Tredegar Road in Jacksonville was broken into. A chainsaw, two weed trimmers, circular saw, diamond thread toolbox, and assorted tools were stolen. Between March 19th and 20th, a black utility trailer was stolen from a residence on Clara Day Drive in Alexandria. Between March 22nd and 23rd, about 48 feet of chain link fencing was stolen from the area of Golden Valley Road and Pelamanard Road in Ohatchee. Between March 20th and 21st, an outbuilding located on Wellington Road in Jacksonville was broken into. A chainsaw, weed eater, backpack, blower, and skill saw were stolen. Between March 25th and 26th, two outbuildings located on Highway 144 in Alexandria were broken into. Nothing reported stolen at this time. Between March 25th and 29th, a residence on Dripping Rock Road in Piedmont was broken into. A television, refrigerator, and some other household items were stolen. Between March 27th and 29th, a residence on Francis Mill Road in Ohatchee was broken into. Firearms were stolen here. And between March 25th and 27th, a toy-built pressure washer was stolen from a resident on Angel Drive South in Jacksonville. If you have any information about these cases, call Calhoun County Crime Stoppers at 256-238-1414. They want your information, not your name, and you could get a cash reward of up to $1,000.
Stupid! You're so stupid!
Regardless of what some people think, police and deputies try to be helpful and friendly when they can. Had an incident this week where someone came out to check on a domestic disturbance, and when they had finished with the report, they offered the lady involved a ride to get her away from where this had happened.
That happens.
Yeah. That's a good idea, right?
That's a good idea.
Okay. Well, they did inform her that she had a beverage. She was not going to be able to bring that with her.
That's told to people often as well.
Yeah. So then her question was, well, I got a little weed here. Will that be okay?
Yes, it'll be okay. And we appreciate people who tell us those kind of things. You know, I actually pulled somebody over one time and they had a joint right here behind their ear, like a cigarette. I said, you got any marijuana in the car? And they're like, no. I said, you sure? And they're like, I'm positive. I said, well, what about this joint behind your ear? He goes, you got me. So we appreciate those easy ones.
Yeah, she did end up managing to get a ride in the back of the car. She just didn't go to the same place that she was planning on originally.
Yeah, she got a free night, free stay, and some food, I'm sure.
Yeah, it was a bad day for her.
Not a very smart, you know, sometimes it just happens.
Yeah, it does. Well, again, we want to thank you for all the great information that you have shared with us. Another six individuals arrested this week. We've got another lineup for you. If you just tuned in and missed the lineup this week, you can find it on the Facebook page for the Calhoun County Sheriff's Office. And then we will be back again next week. Hopefully, we'll see you, but not in the lineup on Calhoun County's Most Wanted.